On December 31st, as people across the world ushered in the new year 2023, a stampede ensued at the Namasua-based Freedom City as revelers scrambled to have a glimpse of the firework displays. According to police, the event security team had locked four exits and entries to the event venue, leaving the over 5,000 revelers to use a single door for entry and exit.
The celebrations were progressing well till that point where the master of ceremony recklessly made an announcement for the concert goers to move out and watch the fireworks display in the parking and probably thereafter return to the concert. Now the packed crowd became dangerous after the rush for fireworks from the hall through a narrow corridor to the only exit entry point led to a panic mode because the local security guards had locked all the other gates. Okay, about four other exits.
This saga has claimed 10 lives while dozens are still hospitalized. Police say they have arrested the event's organizer, Abi Musingzi, alias Abtex, and he will be charged with negligence. Police also said parents whose children got injured in the stampede will be questioned for letting underage children get into an adult music scene.
In addition to that, we are also going to take action because if you noticed amongst the deceased persons, we have children who are under 18 years. And of course, children below 18 are not required to attend adult concerts. It is only those who are 18 and above that are permitted to attend such concerts because they are legally allowed to make their own decisions as adults. For those who are like 13 and 17, they can attend if they are accompanied by an adult or responsible person. We have, like I've indicated, Abe Musinguzi, the promoter or organizer of the event, is already in custody.
Enanga further blamed the mess on organizers who seem to prioritize profit than safety of revelers, and in this incident did the same to avoid gate crushers. Meanwhile, the Criminal Investigations Directorate, Crime Intelligence, Counterterrorism and Forensics into the incident are still ongoing to ascertain whether there were enough stewards to help in crowd control, but also paramedics to help in case of any incident.
Our specialist teams from CID, Forensics, Counterterrorism and Crime Intelligence are continuing to carry out investigations. Our areas of interest are the access and exit controls, the safety measures against crowd control, the safety measures against disorders and stampedes, evacuation plans. We want to establish whether paramedics and ambulances were on site, the number of stewards and ushers who were dedicated to the event, and the number of people at the concert, among others.
Also, police in Kamwanja District have arrested two men suspected to be agents of the rebel allied Democratic Forces. These were reportedly carrying out surveillance on one of the police posts in the area. Report compiled by Rachel Natchwala for the news.